So hello everyone, I'm Vincent, I work at Algolia. Today I'm going to talk to you about how we grew and we scaled a productive engineering team from 1 to 60. So I was the fifth engineer at Algolia 3 years ago, and nowadays we are 56 engineers and 178 employees. We will talk about how we grew, the challenges and the scaling solutions that we put in place. So growing, let's break it down year by year, just for, because every presentation starts with bad graphs. So I have graphs for you. In blue, you have the new engineers that we hired every year, and in red, the total of the team. So what we can see is that starting in 2012, we had only Julien Lemoine and our CTO. In 2013, we had our VP engineering. And so every year we doubled the team basically, but in 2016, that was tough. We had challenges behind it. And also, let's talk a bit about productivity now, because this talk is about productivity a bit. So productivity at Algolia, how it went. We don't follow any specific framework. We don't have any specific agile process. We don't do poker planning or follow the velocity points that can work for some companies. But starting at Algolia, we never did that at the beginning. What we did instead was to give ownership and freedom to people so that they can build the project they want without having any managers that could get into their way. That's how we thought about it. So we asked them to design projects, to build them, and to ship them. And we only implemented some process when we saw issues about this way of thinking. But still, where are we productive today? It's hard to evaluate. It can be subjective. We can compare with other previous experiences that we had. We can have some hints with numbers and graphs again. In terms of new repositories, I computed that on our GitHub. In red, you have the total. In blue, the new repositories per year. So we double the team and we double repositories per year. Is it good or bad? I don't know. We'll see afterwards. The number of commits did not double because actually some at the beginning, maybe people will do a lot of commits for a single feature, and then we implemented some process that said, okay, maybe we can do a single commit for a big feature. So that does not double. I put the blog post also because we are a company where we encourage every engineer to create blog posts and to write blog posts. So this metric is interesting to me. We had 51 blog posts for the whole engineering team last year, so that's nice. So charts are going up. Everything is fine. We won, of course. But that's not maybe the end of the story because productivity is one thing. And today, we would like to introduce a bit more efficiency, not productivity. So productivity, we try to give it, raw productivity, we try to give it to people by giving them the right tools, the right computer, the right working environment, this cool office. But they also need vision. So where is the company heading at? Where is your team heading at? What are your objectives? It seems obvious, but we didn't have that at the very beginning. Not team visions. And focus, of course. So we want people to be able to focus on a single feature, on a single project, to be able to deliver it and to be efficient. Actually, we had some challenges achieving such efficiency at Algolia at some point, and we'll see why. So why? Algolia started as an organization where we said we are flat. So we are really flat, which means we didn't have any teams at the beginning. One engineer could handle multiple projects, so he could deliver one project, but then he could deliver like 5 projects, which can be challenging. And we had a single manager for 30 reports. So that blue dot on the top is basically the VP of engineering. He was the only manager we had, and that was tough for him. So those were the facts, basically where we were at in 2016, something like that. The results of those facts, of the fact that we were flat, where that sometimes we could be slow to deliver. Some engineers, we could be slow to deliver. Why? Because if you are working on 5 projects, it's a lot harder to deliver a good feature on one of those projects. Some engineers also felt left out from their being not able to have tight feedback with their manager. That was ending a lot of people. the onboarding of new engineers was sometimes hard because we didn't spend much time trying to onboard them. We said, okay, welcome. We'll see afterwards what you will do at Algolia. Or do you have any idea already what you want to do at Algolia, which is not easy for people. Overall, the organization was blurry and the responsibilities were not very obvious. Who takes the decisions for projects? In a lot of situations, the VP and the CTOs were go-to person. Like for any discussion, any new project or any decision on a single project, sometimes we will go to see them, which was not easy because they had also responsibilities to do, like scaling the team. So with all of those challenges at some point, I think it was in 2016 at our first company seminar, we had a presentation from our VPs that says, okay, what can we do about that? So the first thing we did was to have squads. So it's teams. As I said, there was not a single team before that. So those teams were useful because then we could say, okay, you are responsible for those projects. So if those projects are not going forward, that's your responsibility. Each squad was and is today between two and five engineers. And we also introduced some tech leads. So I said it was completely flat, but we still introduced some tech leads that could help the teams to take decisions when there was a need for it. We don't have any enforced process. We don't have any enforced company-wide process, but still most of the teams will meet regularly to discuss any subject and to plan their objectives. They define quarterly objectives. They define yearly objectives, and those objectives needs to fit inside the company vision. So for example, the company vision is we want to have the best developer experience. My team, Instant Search for Website, we do UI libraries. We will say, okay, we are going to do a developer tool so that we provide the best developer experience to our users. So that's how we fit squads objectives inside company vision. The next thing we did was to have product managers. We didn't have any product managers. We had only the product people were the developers. But at some point, that does not scale well because developers, they want to focus on code. They can get good feedback and good ideas. But you need someone to own the roadmap, to own the objective and priorities, and also the dependencies between squads. Because some squads, if you need to do a new website for the instant search libraries, you need to have some design, you need to have some front-end people that will do those websites. So they gather a lot of feedback while owning the roadmap, and they do that within the teams. Another part we did, again, to scale, was that is the career framework. So the career framework, what it is. After 2 or 3 years at Algolia, even if you are feeling good at Algolia, even if you are doing great projects, at some point you want to have a career path. You want to see forward. You want to see what's next for me. What can I do? Can I evolve at Algolia? Can I acquire new skills? And for that, we basically did a Google document where we have 2 tracks. You have individual contributor track, leadership track. The leadership track is, for example, engineering managers. There is no golden track. It doesn't mean we don't say being promoted as manager. We say Vincent switched from individual contributor track to leadership track. Inside those tracks, we have levels. So like in a game, but it's not a game, it's real life. We have 10 levels. Inside each level, we have, or 10 or something. Inside each level, we have expectations. And inside those expectations, it helps people figuring out, what do I need to go to the next level? So to go from level 3 to 4, I need to handle the full code base of a single project. I need to maybe go speak at an event, to maybe do some blog post. So it helps having some personal growth. It helps having a career path. And it's an ongoing project, so it always moves. Not too much, so. scaling, again, we did engineering manager. So we had some tech leads. Maybe some of those tech leads wanted to switch to management. We had a VP of engineering that was doing 30 one-on-ones. So we said, okay, do you want to be an engineering manager? So your job will be completely moving, completely changing. What will you do? You will do what I do. Biweekly or weekly one-on-ones with every team members, helping them to grow, helping them achieving their objectives, asking them, is everything going good at Algolia? Do you feel safe at Algolia? What do you need? So we ensure people's health and people performance inside those meetings. We also run team meetings, and we get a lot of feedback from people, and this feedback helps in scaling the team again. Just as so that you know, today we have 56 engineers and we have four engineering managers in 1 year. We added four engineering managers in one year, plus the VP engineering. As for scaling the company as a whole, let's take an example with onboarding. So onboarding, at some point at Allura, it was like that. I have a computer, see you in 2 weeks. If you know what you want to do, that's good. If you don't, that's hard. It's exaggerating, but some of those onboardings were like that. So at some point, we say we can't scale to 50 or to 100 like that. We need to have an onboarding plan. So today, we every engineering manager receives a note saying, OK, you have a new comer in 2 weeks. You need to build an onboarding plan. So the engineering manager will discuss with the team and say, what could we do for this person? We'll do a PDF in two parts. The first part is a 3 weeks small exercise or small achievement. And the second part is a quarterly objective, basically. One of the quarterly objectives that we define, we give it to them. That's all what we did in terms of scaling. What have we learned? What we have learned? It's okay to have teams and managers and still be efficient. Flat is not always the best organization to achieve a good efficiency. An efficient manager is a close manager, is someone that is close to the team and then can understand the challenges of the people, the challenges of the team, and can give actionable feedback. Also, one thing that we always do at Allura is that we don't provide any solution to a problem that does not exist. So we try to identify problem first before bringing any solutions. When I came at Allura, I was like, hey, yeah, we need agile, etc. We were 15. It was a bit too much. And we learned that Allura is still a great place to work. Why I'm saying that? So I have been working for 10 years in the tech industry. And every year and a half, I would leave every company that I joined because I was feeling bored. At Allura, it will be 3 years tomorrow with Alex that is here, and it's still very great to be here. So I think we achieved something great. Good. What's next for us is that we will have to recruit 59 engineers this year. Good luck to the recruiting team, but we also help them. Recruit engineering managers, we are 4, but we need more. Recruit product managers. Challenge the squad's organization, because the more people we'll bring, the squads will change a bit. We don't try to change the squads every 2 months, but still, when we have 50 people to add, we need to challenge them a bit. And we want to keep shipping, of course, keep shipping a lot of projects like we do. We are hiring, as you saw. You can see all the careers here, and that's it. Thank you. If you have any questions, go.
One question there. Can you speak to the difference in culture between your different offices, like here in San Francisco?
Yes. So originally, we didn't want it to have a real separation in terms of teams between SF and Paris. But what we have today is that most of the engineering team is in Paris. And in SF, we have a lot of success engineers and sales. The culture, so I didn't speak about it, but we have 5 values inside our culture: greed, trust, care, candor, and humility. I got them. and every office needs to leave behind those values. So what I could say in terms of difference of culture is only organizational and what people are doing inside each office. But aside from that, what we do well, I think, is that every engineer can go once a year to the SF office, for example, and a lot of people from the SF office are also visiting. So we try to always have people moving. We have corporate apartments in every city to do that, and that helps a lot because I can relate to a lot of people from SF and be close to them.
Other questions? No one? Oh, yes.
How do you build your squads around projects or part of your product? Or
so some of those teams were already a bit defined. Before we did the squads, people regrouped by skills or by projects. So the squads, we made them by product features, yes, basically. So we have a search API squad, we have an instant search squad that is doing UI libraries, an analytics one. So it's really by product features, yes.
Did you went further than squads in terms of organization? Did you went for the chapters and made DevOps teams that meet and share practices, or backend teams that share practices and so on?
In terms of sharing practices, what we do is that we have a show and tell every week where every team can showcase what, or everyone can showcase what he's been doing. Sharing practices between squads is done by a bit of the feedback we get from the teammates, and then we have an engineering manager meeting where we can share what we are doing. But we don't have for now squads groups, for example. We are thinking about it, but it's not today what we have.
Last question, maybe? No? Ah, yes.
So you have one engineering manager per squad or per project?
Can you repeat?
You've got one engineering manager per squad or per project?
So today, it's one engineering manager per squad, yes. It depends on the size of the squad. If the squad is two people, then we will try to have this engineering manager being shared on another squad. But for now, it's one engineering manager per squad, yes.
And the product management, is it inside the squad or outside?
So product management is, in what do you mean by inside?
Well, is he a member of a squad or not?
So one product manager handles multiple squads. So he comes to meetings, she comes to meetings, but she handles multiple squads at the same time, okay. Like two or three. Mm.
Thank you. Thank you, Vincent. I just want to say that we have all our open position on the pillars over there if you're interested. And thank you very much.
Yes. Thank you.